Hey guys, it's Mackenzie. Welcome back to my channel. So today I have yet another huge cumulative thrift outlet haul. This time we have about 100 items that I sourced over the last couple of weeks from my two favorite outlet stores here in Houston, both the Goodwill outlet, otherwise known as the Goodwill bins, where I pay $2.19 per pound, as well as the Family Thrift Center outlet, where I go pretty much every Thursday morning and I pay $2 per item at that store. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. Like I said, we do have 100 items, so I will have to move just a little bit faster for this haul. I probably paid right around $200, maybe $235-ish for everything you will see in this haul. So let's go ahead and get into it. Our first item is this purse. I'm gonna start off with this and shoes, and then we will move into clothing. So I just grabbed this from the bins. I liked the neutral stripe, and these lucite circular handles have been pretty trendy. It's just vintage Liz Claiborne. So I thought it was cute, kind of Y2K 90s-esque. Into shoes. First off, this pair of Toms. And I will pick up Toms if they are a little bit higher quality than just the kind of fabric, little like slip-on laceless tennis shoe kind of thing. So these are a heeled slingback mule with a leather upper. Really nice condition. This back heel here, there's little to nothing taken out of the sole, which is what I like to see. These are size 10. Next up, a very exciting shoe find. These are Free People, which I always really like finding their accessories. And these, once again, genuine leather. They're like a metallic sheen, strappy sandal. Once again, great shape. This footbed doesn't show much wear at all. These are a size 41, made in India. I think these were handmade, very high quality. Paul Green, speaking of high quality, this brand retails for like $300 to $400 just because the shoes are so well made and the leather is always really nice. So these are like a block heel, open toe sandal. These are handmade. They say size 6, but you do have to convert Paul Green sizing, so they're probably closer to like an 8 or a 9. And last pair of shoes are these J. Crew smoking loafers. So cute with the metallic leopard print, size 8.5. Okay. Oh, actually we have one more kind of accessory here. This is a bra. I just grabbed this because it was Victoria's Secret and I believe it's new with tags. It still has this paper kind of tag here that says the size 38D, and it's just a really nice, pretty, lacy bra. Okay, so now we will move into clothing. First off, we have this Altered State, size small, fuzzy, furry vest. It's a neutral color, open front, long line. I just threw this on my mannequin to give a better idea of fit. I think this would be so cute over like a long sleeve. This is great for transitional weather like springtime because it provides a little bit of warmth, but it's not like a full-on jacket or anything, and it's super cute. So this is one of my absolute favorite brands to find, Flax, just because it sells so well. It's usually natural materials, linen, cotton, and these styles are almost always very kind of minimalist, contemporary. This dress is no exception. This is probably one of my favorite finds from this brand ever. I just love the two-tone grid print. It's like a window pane grid print. Slouchy pockets at the bottom hem. You have a rolled sleeve. This is 100% linen and it's a size small. Okay, another really fun find. This definitely stands out, this piece in particular from Free People as well, size medium. So this is a maxi jumpsuit, and it is extremely wide leg. So I don't think you can get much more boho and interesting than this piece. This is so cool. I could see this selling for around $50 to $65, which is awesome. Let's see the, oh, I said it's a size medium. It buttons up at the chest, and overall it's just kind of like a shapeless, very loose fitting jumpsuit, which a lot of people like. It's easy to throw on and go. You don't really have to, you definitely don't have to think about your outfit too much because you don't have to match with this. This is a throw it on and you're ready to walk out the door kind of piece. So we love that. Okay, this I was actually debating on buying at the store, and I'm kind of mad at myself for that because I am absolutely in love with it now that I've gotten it home. It's just Ann Taylor, which is part of the reason that I was kind of on the fence about it. But it is 100% extra fine merino wool, and it is a two-piece matching set. So you have, it's like a cross between a zebra and tiger. It's like a tiger print in a zebra colorway. And you have, it's like some ruching at the little top, and then the matching button-down cardigan. So I did model this. This is very 90s and Y2K, which is super in. And then when you add the quality material, the print, you have a very, very sellable little set there. I was thrilled about that when I got it home and realized just how amazing it is. Okay, next up we have this sweatshirt. This may not look like much, pretty basic, but this brand is 100% something that you guys need to keep your eyes peeled for. It didn't have a brand tag at the neck, but the inner tag confirmed that this is Joa Brown. So Joa and then Brown. And this stuff, it doesn't retail for crazy high, but the demand is insane. If there's a sports bra that retailed for like $60, you can resell it for like $45 to $50. It's one of those brands that keeps its resale value very well. This sweatshirt I could see selling for $35 to $50. It probably originally retailed for around $65. It's like a Sherpa material with a V cut in back. Okay, next up, this was just a kind of style and material based pickup. I liked this color. It's like a cheery orange color. It's a tiered bodice with this gauzy cotton. It's 100% cotton. The brand really meant nothing to me. It just says Pat Pat, whatever that is. I think it's probably just like a lower end boutique size medium. I will pick up boutique stuff if the quality is there. And with this being 100% cotton, has adjustable straps, it looks pretty well made. I do not shy away from getting items like that. Next we have JOA, which stands for Just One Answer. I am kind of picky with this brand. It does, I think it has like, not, I wouldn't say a high retail price, but it does, you know, retail for a pretty penny. Like the sweater was probably like 75 to 85-ish originally would be my guess. But I will only get it if the style is really nice, where it has, you know, like a nice material going for it. I just like this twist front with the semi-cropped kind of fit. This, again, brand did not matter to me. It doesn't even have a brand at the collar. I absolutely love the color palette to this. I thought it was very sweet and feminine. It buttons down in front, and then it has these kind of like metallic inlays, like mesh inlays. And the material is 38% wool, 33% kid mohair, and then acrylic and nylon. So I did model this just to kind of show how adorable it is on as well. Next, we have a vintage Pendleton skirt. I did look this tag up on fashionguild.com, or is it vintagefashionguild.com? That's how I date tags. And I think it showed that this was from the 60s. I could be wrong on that, but it is definitely vintage. So it's a midi skirt, 100% wool with pleating. And then within the pleats, there's this really cool like earth tone plaid print. So I absolutely could not leave this behind. Midi skirts sell amazing for me as it is. And then when you combine the fact that this is a well-known brand, Pendleton, it's pure virgin wool, and it's a size 10. You have a very kind of marketable item there. Just bread and butter here, LL Bean, size medium. Any kind of athleisure, casual style dresses like this, I will pick up for sure, especially if they have a cute print. And this one was actually new with tags, retailed for $55. It's like sweat wicking, soft, stretchy, very wearable. Another piece based on style. Tell me this is not the cutest jumpsuit ever. It's like a contrasting blue and green stripe with a cropped wide leg. And this green portion, you can either tie in front like I have it, or you can wrap it around and tie it in back. The brand is MSK, size small. Another brand I love finding, James Percy. This stuff retails for a ton. This dress is probably about $250 originally. It's like a color block, black and gray with some ruched detailing. So flattering. From the beginning of my reselling journey, dresses from James Percy have always sold incredibly well for me. Dresses and skirts, I would say. Within that $40 to $65-ish range. Also jackets. Anything of a more substantial cut from James Percy does very, very well. So yeah, I'll expect probably $45 to $50-ish on that. And he does have a little bit of a different kind of sizing. So size one, all you have to do is Google James Percy size chart and it pulls up all the conversions for you. I think size one is equivalent to small. Next up, just a closet staple here. We have J. Crew, size small, V-neck sweater. I grabbed this mainly because it looked brand new. It had no pilling, no holes, no wear, and it's 100% merino wool. So we love some solid wardrobe staples. Super cute piece here. This is Lucky Brand. This is not the most substantial piece from Lucky Brand. It's just a little tank, but I did like that it is a genuine wrap top, which genuine wrap stuff does sell great for me. It has a boho print, and I figured I could model this just to show how cute it is, size small. So this jacket, I don't know if I should have gotten it, mainly because it does have some spots that I was not able to get out, but it was a slow bins day and I just wanted to get a couple things. So I did end up getting it. I think the style is really cool, and anything in this like military-esque kind of vibe has always sold great for me. It's a double-breasted long line coat with some frayed edges and kind of subtle interesting details. The tag, it's like pretty much all faded, so I can't really read anything. It says size small, I can see that, but I don't know. I'm gonna try to clean it up and see. Maybe I'll just list it for like 30-ish, 25 to 30-ish. It is super cool though. So we'll see on that. Okay, next up we have J. Jill. I've actually recently just sold this dress. This is my second time finding it at the bins. It's 100% linen and it is a newer piece. It's still selling online, or it was when I last sold it, which was like a month ago. So it might have sold out by now, but just a nice kind of buttoned down shirt dress in, you know, linen. So this will be great for spring, summertime. And I love finding items that I have sold in the past because I just go to the listing, copy and paste everything over, title, description, and my listing is already built for me. more J.Crew. This one is actually new with tags, which we love to see. It doesn't have the retail price on it, but I'm guessing maybe like $100 to $150 because this is 100% silk. It's a popover blouse. Popover just means that it buttons, but it doesn't button all the way down. It has two chest pockets in a really pretty cobalt blue color. We have more Free People and my favorite color. This is the Ventura Thermal. I have sold this like 75 times since reselling. Not really, maybe like 10. It's very slouchy, waffle knit, kind of mixed textures and raw hems. I think Free People calls it drippy, which is not my favorite word to describe it, but it basically just means that it's very slouchy and oversized, boho, all the type of characteristics that sell best within Free People. Another lucky brand, these are just kind of like bundle items, closet filler pieces. I did, once again, like this print. This was something that I just thought was super cool. It's like a pinafore suspender style skirt dress type item with a Glen plaid print. It is a wool blend. I just threw this on my mannequin to show how it would fit. The brand is Joan Leslie, and it does fit like a size small. Okay, I did open the window just because it is very warm in here. So hopefully it's not too distracting for you guys. Okay, so next up, we have this really nice Madewell utility anorak style jacket in a salmon color. It does zip as well as snap in front. It has the drawstring inside, so that you can cinch it to be a little bit more flattering. And this is a size large. So, next is this really pretty long line duster length cardigan. And it does have an all over pointelle knit to it. That is a keyword. Really pretty, just, you know, a great kind of boho layering piece, and I like the trim to it. Torrid. I love finding Torrid. I would say it's one of my best bread and butter brands. This one is a size 4X, super soft knit. I think it is new without tags just because it shows no signs of wear and it still has the little tag stub. So it's like a soft, stretchy knit upper with this floral print. It is a tiered design, fully lined, really pretty. This is something, again, it was a slow day at the bins and I was just kind of reaching for stuff. It is dead stock vintage, which just means that it's a vintage item, but it's still new with tags. It was sold at Foley's. The brand is By Choice. Something about it just kind of spoke to me. I think it's this contrasting floral print with the little tie front. Very 90s. So maybe I'll model that to kind of show my vision. And lastly, for our very first bag, we do have three bags total, is this Coldwater Creek. I guess it's like a cardigan style blazer. It in a size 14 to 16, which is great. I do not pick up this brand very often, but every once in a while there will be just kind of like a mixture of characteristics that make it really sellable. In this case, it is that larger size. It's 100% linen. It's in my best selling category, which is like cardigan slash topper style item. Waterfall draped front with this subtle like herringbone print. So excited about that. Moving on to bag number two. First off, really pretty Free People blouse. The style name on this is the JoJo top. And once again, you have that very soft, stretchy jersey knit body with some sheer lace accents. And this is so pretty. The stock photos were gorgeous. The size tag was ripped out at the neck, but it actually had it at the material tag. So that was really nice. Next up, we have J. Crew Factory, size small. And I got this mainly because it was new at tags, $64.50. Really cute print. It's almost like an indigo kind of look. It's like a artistic polka dot kind of style crew neck sweatshirt. This, once again, is a brand that I would say 60 to 75% of the time do not usually buy, BCBG Max Azria. But once again, this particular piece had several things going for it. First off, it is a silk and cashmere blend, so very high quality materials. Also, it is in a cardigan style, and it's a super interesting kind of style and fit. So I'm not gonna be able to show it now, but it's long line, and then it has these ties near the waist that you kind of wrap around your waist and tie. I did put this on my mannequin, so I'll include pictures. So yeah, I'll expect maybe like 35 to 40-ish from that. It is definitely going to sell based on material and cut. Next, Peruvian Connection, size large. This is a tie-dye maxi dress. I love finding this brand, preferably in an alpaca material. That is what this brand is most known for. But with this being a stretch jersey knit, that's still a pretty desirable fabric because it is very wearable, very soft and cozy and comfy. This is a brand that I have recently wanted to start trying out. I heard Mogi Beth over at, I think her YouTube channel is Mogi Beth. I heard her saying that she wanted to try it out because she had received it in some of her liquidation orders and it sold relatively well for her. And so she was going to try to start, you know, trying it out within the secondhand, like thrift stores, sourcing it from thrift stores and see how it does. So I figured, because, you know, I didn't know that this brand retailed for a lot at all. And so when I heard that, I did find, I think, several pieces within this haul that seemed pretty substantial to me. So this one is a size 1X, which is great. It has a really cool design to it. And it is a cotton linen blend. Actually, no. No linen, just cotton, but still really cool. It was in excellent condition, so for $2, I am happy to try that out. Okay, next, once again, a brand that I leave behind quite often, but I absolutely could not for this piece. This is just Loft from Ann Taylor Loft in a size medium with that contrasting floral print and this super puff sleeve, has elastic. This is so cute. It also buttons down and back all the way down. I found two Lululemon tanks that I believe are the same size, both size 8. This one is a black color and then this one is blue. So I will just lot these together. Lululemon tanks do not sell like they used to. You could get like 28 to 35-ish per tank, and now I would say it's closer to like 15 to 20-ish. So I might lot those up for like 35, around 35. Next, another new tags. This is newer tag American Eagle, which I do like to get. It's definitely a bread and butter, like bundle type brand for me. Size medium, it retailed for 35. And I just liked the colorful stripe with these tortoiseshell buttons. New attacks, can't beat it. These are Kimchi Blue by Urban Outfitters. This is an Urban Outfitters house brand, size 10. So I got these for several reasons. First off, because of the size 10. Also the cut, they have a paper bag waist, which is a keyword. It's a very trendy, kind of sought after waistline for a lot of people. They're wide leg, cropped, so very contemporary, minimalist, boho. These kind of overlap into a lot of style categories. This is a brand that I do like to sell. I don't find it that often out in the wild when I'm sourcing, but I have found it on, where's the tag? On ThredUp outlet several times, and it has always sold great for me. It's Blue Life, size small. This is just a little mini dress. Probably sell for like 28 to 32, possibly 35-ish. Cut out in back with a little tie, and the print is a polka dot floral. We have Vintage Gap here. So I got this mainly because it's like a Fair Isle Nordic kind of print, which always does great for me, in combination with it being 100% wool. So it's pretty high quality. And I did also like the cut. So this is the little vintage tag. Next up, another bundle listing that I will do. These, I don't think, are substantial enough on their own to list, you know, individually, but together, I think this would be a really nice kind of soft, cozy bundle for someone. First item is American Eagle size medium tie-dye crew neck sweatshirt, bundled with this Morona from Target striped turtleneck top. This is, it has like a fleece feel to it, so this is very soft. And lastly, Abercrombie and Fitch from their soft and cozy line. They're all size medium, all extremely soft and in excellent condition. No pilling or signs of wear. This one has ribbed trims. So yeah, those three will be one bundle, probably for like 35, possibly 40-ish. Beyond Yoga, this is like an athletic, athleisure line, which does pretty well, size small. I liked this kind of crossover wrap front. This kind of piece is so easy to throw on over your sports bra when you're finished working out at the gym and you need to walk back to your car, but you don't, you know, want to put on like a form-fitting tank or top. Another piece where the brand meant nothing to me, I've never heard of this, Ollie and Hallie. It's a size large, but I loved the style of this. So it's a V-neck, super slouchy, oversized top with these very dramatic kind of batwing style sleeves. And they are actual sleeves. So, you know, they don't connect to the blouse, which I feel like you don't always see. It also, lastly, is 72% modal and spandex. Modal, if you're unfamiliar, is the softest material in the entire world. And when you add spandex, you know, it's just a soft, stretchy, nice, wearable piece. More Torrid, size 1X, pretty floral print tunic top. It's high low with a little tie at the sleeve and cutout. Super cute. We have All Saints, another brand I love to find. Super high retail price with this brand. This is the brand right here, All Saints, and this is a size 10. It's this heather gray cropped, like dolman style hoodie. Very slouchy and for sure an interesting cut. You have some contrast seams there and a drawstring. Loved this piece from Free People. It's from their Intimately line, size medium. And it's like a baby doll style jumpsuit. So you have elastic at the neckline and sleeves and waist. And then it's a wide leg cropped fit jumpsuit. And the stripes, it has a contrasting stripe print, so it's lighter up top than the bottom. It does have pockets, and it's a linen cotton blend. Speaking of linen, we have Cynthia Rowley 100% linen. This is yet another brand that I do not always buy. I don't run for it by any means, but with this being linen and a really fun, vibrant print, I did go ahead and get it. I think this will be an amazing spring summer dress for someone, size small. And it also looked like it had never been worn. It does have pockets, which is always nice. More Free People. I modeled this once again, mainly because I could tell that it would be super cute on, but it's kind of hard to gather that from it hanging on the hanger. So it's a navy gray stripe, and it does have, it's 25% mohair, so very soft and luxurious. This was a great find. It is Cecilia Prado, which this brand is sold at Anthropologie, size small, really pretty. It's like, it looks like a, is that needlepoint or cross stitch? It's one of the two that it's supposed to look like, but it's not actually that kind of design. It's just more like a print. And it is a maxi dress. It also has this kind of like fuzzy texture to it. I'm not sure if it's coming across. It does have side slits. I was gonna see if that texture was like mohair, but I don't see the fabric tag. Athleta, size extra large. I was so excited to find this, mainly because it is their newer Athleta tag and it's in a size extra large. It looks brand new, and I can already tell this is a modal blend. It is, yeah, 67% modal polyester and spandex. This thing is so soft. Even basics from Athleta, if it's the newer tag or larger size, sell amazing for me. So I do pick them up. J. Crew, size 14 tall, which is, once again, a great size. I feel like you don't see that too often. This is a velvet, is it a wrap top? Can't tell. No. I think it's just supposed to look like a wrap top, and then you have a tie. It's a V-neck velvet texture. It's fully lined. It zips on the side. And this is from fall of 2018. So really nice, kind of elegant piece there. Lululemon reversible sweater. I did look this up already, but of course I forget. I think it's like Chai Time reversible sweater. It does have some pilling, which I obviously will disclose, but I couldn't leave it with it being reversible. And I think someone, you know, a lot of people don't mind some light pilling. Next, we have Flax, once again, size petite, which just means I'll list it as small. I'll list it as small petite. And it is 100% linen. This is a button down top in this very earthy kind of color and texture. Is that picking up? There we go. So, love this. I'll probably expect, I would say 35-ish on that. This is a vintage little dress, so cute. I could not get over the details on this. So the buttons are pearls, and I mean, I really could not. It's so cute. It laces up and back. You have like a pastel floral print. This is the tag, Jody Michaels. So I will be sure to include keywords like 90s, Y2K, cottagecore, prairie, anything that someone might be typing in to look for a dress like that. Next we have Madewell, size small. I was super excited to find this because it is a longer length dress, which sells amazing for me, from brands like Free People, Madewell, Anthropologie. It has a side slit. It's 100% linen. Actually, no, I don't think it's 79% linen and 21% cotton, but still all natural materials. And this is from summer of 2020. It looks brand new. Sometimes I cannot believe the stuff that I'm able to find. It's crazy. Okay. I have been picking up this brand, Easel Los Angeles, which is just a boutique brand. Once again, like I was mentioning earlier, it has to have a higher quality to it. So this with the kind of intentionally frayed, distressed seams, the tie-dye print, the wide neckline, and the material were all reasons that did make me think it is a little bit higher quality. Yeah, 100% cotton. So I had to get this. I think it's so cute. If that were 100% polyester, I would have left it behind. But you know, that could easily just be Free People, because a lot of Free People items are 100% cotton. They have cute details to them like that. I was unfamiliar with this brand, Saltwater Luxe, size extra small, but I got it mainly based on style. It has this micro polka dot print. It's a long line, open front, kind of duster cardigan. So I thought this would be like a fun boho chic kind of vibe addition to your wardrobe, your outfit, if it's like a monochromatic kind of look. More Torrid, 4X. This was a Ben's grab. Again, it's that really soft stretch jersey knit. It's a high-low hemline, and then the back has this really pretty embroidered detail. It's like, what is that called? Applique. There we go. It's like an applique, floral applique with a ruffle hem and back. And lastly, for our second bag, is yet another Free People, just a little mini dress with lots of details. You have two knots in front, contrasting print, some cutouts here and back, pockets, actually no pockets, scratch that, size extra small. Alrighty, third and final bag. So, starting off with a bang, this is Vintage Givenchy Sport, size 38. So cool, little collared pullover sweatshirt kind of top. I'm not sure if the color is coming across as nicely as it is in real life, but it's like this, I don't even know how you would describe it. It's like an orangey brown, really pretty, and then you do have the embroidered logo here towards the bottom hem. So pretty. That's in excellent condition despite being vintage. Speaking of vintage, I absolutely loved this find. The print on this is like, this is like what I dream about. Like if I could create a print, it would be this. I mean, it is so pretty. I don't even think I'm going to be able to do this justice on camera, but the sleeves are contrasting, and then, and to top it all off, it is so flattering on. I feel like I'm not holding it correctly. There we go. So yeah, it's long line, very flattering. I did model this for the listing. It only has this tag at the neckline, which just says 9/10. It fits like a small medium, I would say. I was pretty excited for this because I've never found this brand before, which is a definite bolo, universal standard. This is for J. Crew, which I feel like it's not gonna sell as well if it were just universal standard, but that's okay. I am not complaining at all. Really beautiful color. It's like a high mock neck with a bubble sleeve. So pretty. It's long line, size extra large. And I believe it also was a nicer, it's 30% wool. Very soft and cozy. Next, we have M by Missoni, which is a diffusion line within Missoni, but honestly, it's still very expensive because, you know, Missoni is a designer brand. So this is a little tank with their signature kind of colorful print. And it does have, I have this looped around the armhole so I won't lose it. It is supposed to go around the waist though. It's a little belt. This is precious. I love this piece, little silver kind of squares at the shoulders. I did put this on my mannequin just to show how nicely it fits. I would recommend if you are planning to be a full-time reseller that you do get a mannequin if you're not wanting to model. Or even like me, I do model, but you know, I don't always have the time to change and everything. So when I'm in a pinch, I just throw stuff on my mannequin that I feel like the hanger doesn't do it justice, and it definitely does help it sell better. I think as long as your buyer is able to get a pretty good picture of how the piece fits and sits and flatters, then it's definitely more likely to sell. Okay, this is a Velvet by Graham & Spencer, which this brand is pretty expensive as well. It's, I would say, around $100 retail. It is sometimes sold at Anthropologie. This is their vintage slub line, and this is a size extra large. It's a cardigan waterfall drape front in this slub knit. So pretty. Also new with tags. I have no idea what was going on. This was originally sold through Stitch Fix. And so I had to throw that into my cart. More Free People. This is from their Free People 1 line, which I do really like finding. They have a lot of like intricate kind of designs, a lot of fraying, and more like delicate fabrics, I would say. So this is a smocked chest, little cropped blouse in a very gauzy cotton material. Has two buttons in back with a little keyhole opening. So cute. All Saints, once again, size large. This is definitely one of my favorite, I would say kind of higher tier bread and butter brands, just because I do find it pretty often, but it does retail a little bit higher. So you have this fold over neckline with a ribbed kind of chunky knit and a cutout here at the shoulder with a tie. So very interesting, contemporary, minimalist, really cool cut and fit there. Even more Torrid. I feel like I have the same brands in this haul, but I know it sells and I stick to it for the most part. Size 1/2, which I think I looked up and it was like 14 to 16 maybe-ish. And this I was so excited to find because not only is it one of my best-selling brands in a great plus size, but it also is in one of my best-selling cuts, which is like cardigan, kimono, duster style with this really amazing boho print. How cute would this be in the summertime with some denim shorts, a little t-shirt, and then this over top? I'm very excited for summertime, if you guys cannot tell. I know I've mentioned it like 6 times in this video. It actually was in the 80s yesterday here in Texas, in Houston. There were people in my apartment complex swimming in our pool. So I kind of got a taste of summer yesterday. Equipment, size small, beautiful, cardigan. This is a sweater. Yeah, beautiful sweater. V-neck, 100% cashmere in a neutral leopard print. Really pretty. No holes or pilling on that, thankfully. Another style-based pickup, this is once again just kind of a mid-level boutique brand, Mustard Seed, but this is a size large. It's a striped print and it has this interesting knot detail in front. So with the style, the cut, the size, I had to go ahead and get this tried and true band t-shirt here from the Rolling Stones. Classic graphic there with some paint splatters. I think someone cropped this themselves, which I just noted in the listing. It's a size large. To complete the band tee outfit, you have these 501 Levi shorts. I pick these up every single time I find them at the bins or wherever I am because they do sell really well come summertime. Anything 501 with the button fly. There, these are a size 26, I think. 28. I think I have a size 26 already in my closet. Another item from Madewell. This one's really nice, very substantial. Size small. This is the older tag. I know that because it says 1937 there under the brand, which they don't make this tag anymore. But I couldn't leave it because, like I said, it is very substantial. It's a nice fabric blend, very contemporary. It's like that layered look, so it looks like you have a shirt dress on with a sweater over it, which is really cool. That has always been a style that has sold great for me, the layered look. Yeah, it's a wool alpaca blend. So, and it was in amazing condition. Again, no pilling, no holes. Another style-based pickup. I think this is just sold at Nordstrom and Nordstrom Rack. It's one state, size large. But I did like the cut to it. It's a V-neck with this smocked sleeve or smocked wrist and an interesting little print. We have Denim and Supply by Ralph Lauren, which they do not make this line anymore, Denim and Supply, but a lot of people really liked it. So I do try to get it when I find it because the people that did really like it can't get it on the retail market anymore because, you know, they don't make it. So they do have to turn to the secondhand market. Adorable sleeve with like this tiered ruffle and some elastic. It does have a little tie closure there at the neckline, drawstring at the bottom hem, and overall a very cute boho floral print, size extra small. This was a very fun haul. I really liked every single thing that I found, so that's always really fun and exciting. Torrid, size 4X, high-low dress here with this kind of abstract print. Maybe it's not high-low. Yeah, I don't think it's high-low. I'm thinking of something else. Smocked back, adjustable straps, does have pockets. Billabong is quickly becoming one of my favorite bread and butter brands. It seems like people are actively searching for it. It sells really well. It brings traffic to my closet. This is a cute striped neutral print long line cardigan. It's open front. It has pockets at the hips. It's very soft. It's just cotton and rayon. More J. Crew. I swear, I feel like I just have a lot of the same brands in this haul, but again, tried and true. This one is also new with tags, size 4. 100% silk, ruffles, button down. It also has some pleating at the buttons. Really pretty and feminine. You could dress that up, dress it down, wear it to the office, wear it to brunch. We have yet another cardigan. The brand is Retro Threads, which I had never heard of, but I did get it for a combination of reasons. First off, it's a size large. The style is obviously adorable. It's long line, it has a fringe trim one button closure in front, and I believe it also is 100% cotton. Yeah, 100% cotton. So again, if this were polyester, I would not have gotten it, but the quality factor was definitely there. J. Crew, made with Liberty fabric. I've actually never found the Liberty fabric collab with J. Crew before, so I was happy to see this. Really pretty feminine blouse with some ruffles on the sleeve. I'm not sure if they're showing up. They are the same color. But look at that print, so pretty. I love the kind of dark background. I'm the type of person, if I wear a floral print, I like the more subdued kind of darker look. This is from 2019, size medium. More Free People. This is called the London Town thermal top, which once again, I have sold in the past. Love the color on this. Very slouchy, very oversized. Lots of kind of contrast stitching, asymmetric hem. So this type of style piece material I've sold several times in the past, and it sells consistently for me for around $40 to $45. It's Tahari 100% linen, and it's a dress. I have sold button-down tops, blouses, I'm trying to think, dresses, all in 100% linen from Tahari, and they've consistently sold for me. And this one is 3X, which is amazing. It's a button-down shirt dress in this kind of like chambray look to it. So really pretty. That one also has pockets. Fun jumpsuit here. I see this brand all the time. I never usually get it, but this piece in particular had quite a bit going for it, in my opinion, size extra small. So underneath this ruffle here, you have a smocked chest, which is form-fitting, and then you have the ruffle over top with the wide leg and ruffle bottom hem jumpsuit. So cute. Jumpsuits and rompers sell really well for me, and then when you combine this boho print and cut, I think this should sell very quickly for, I would say, 25 to 32-ish. Next up, we have another dress. This is by the brand Ishakti. I'm not quite sure how to say it. Size 8. And I mainly picked this up because of the print. Anything with like stars or celestial kind of prints sells great, which this definitely has. Really pretty flattering chest with a banded waist. And then this is a close-up of the print. It's like the night sky with an ombre kind of base color. Zips and back. More of that Nick and Zoe, which I'm excited, super excited to get this listed and see how it does. This one is a size petite small, but I did love the kind of colorway to this and the style. It's a cardigan, open front. It does drape with an asymmetric hem. Really pretty. This one, I think, is the linen blend. Yeah, 52% linen. Zara pants with a tie waist. They're that cropped wide leg fit. Once again, very kind of contemporary. And they have, it's like a micro houndstooth print. I'm not sure if you guys will see that. They are a pull-on pant with an elastic waist. These are a size small. This brand, I have heard from a few other resellers, sells pretty well. I think they wear it on like the Real Housewives show. I could be wrong, but I have been wanting to try it out for a long time. I found this at the bins, so I figured it's not much of a risk. It's a little strapless tank with a tie-dye print, and I did model this for the listing. It has a really cool kind of braided design to it. size extra small. So yeah, we'll see how that does. I always love experimenting with new brands and adding more brands to my list that I'm looking on the lookout for. The best place to experiment is at the Goodwill outlet because I probably paid like $1.50 for that top. So even if I have to take it to Plato's, they usually pay me around $4 per item. I'm still gonna make a profit on it. So there's virtually no loss. This is Athleta. Once again, it is a newer piece in a very soft, stretchy material, size medium. We have my favorite brand. I don't think I've had any pieces from this brand until now, which is crazy to me. I usually find it pretty often. Soft surroundings, size petite medium. This is super cute though, so I feel like it makes up for it. It's an kind of asymmetric button down top in this really pretty purple plum color. It has roll tab sleeves. This feels like a lyocell, almost like a chambray. Yeah, 100% tinsel lyocell. So it should drape really nicely on the body and be very flattering. We have more J. Crew. This is so pretty. This is again one of their newer tags. It's a size 4. It's a crushed velvet wrap dress. It's actually untied right now, which is a little bit of a bummer. Usually I try to get everything presentable before the haul, but I was kind of in a time crunch, so I'm just gonna hold it up. So yeah, you can kind of get the idea. It's a wrap dress. Really pretty. This is the sleeve. How adorable would this be for like a gender reveal party or a baby shower? Anything really. So cute. Okay, another brand, kind of like that Easel Los Angeles mustard seed. This is a boutique, mid-tier boutique brand. The font is actually missing, but if you look super closely, you can see that it did say POL or Pole. I do like getting this brand. It does sell pretty well. This is a size 3X to top it off in this really cool tie-dye striped print. It's a popover top, and you have the mismatched buttons, which I always think is such a fun detail. You see that a lot on Free People stuff. More Torrid, 1X, just a rust colored pair of pull-on and go shorts. They have that paper bag waist look. These were in great condition. Hell Bunny, this brand I think is sold at like Hot Topic. I could be wrong, but some items are more desirable than others. I'm not sure on this piece, but it was a size large and it is in that kind of pinup rockabilly style. So I'll add keywords, rockabilly, pinup, gothic. There are some more that I can't think of right now, but people usually do search out those words for dresses like that. My pile is kind of scaring me. It's extremely tall. Okay, finally getting down to our last items here. We have a graphic t-shirt. Every little thing is gonna be all right. Bob Marley quote, really cool, especially with this cutout design. I think someone did this, but they did it really well. It goes down the sleeves, and then the bottom hem has it as well. I think, I forget what this measured like, but it is a larger size. I wanna say like, large or extra large, so I could not leave that behind. Another floral vintage dress by All That Jazz. This one is like a midi maxi length, has like a purple and green print. It also laces up the back like the other one, so I will add like grunge 90s Y2K cottagecore, prairie, those are all the keywords I can think of right now. Okay, last couple items. Madewell, size small. This is called the curved hem sweater dress. because it has a curved hem and it is a sweater dress. It's in this ribbed knit, and let me see, it's a wool blend, 35% wool. And our very last item is Free People. It's We the Free, and it's a size small tunic top, tie-dye, super cute. You can lounge in this, you can run errands in this. It has pockets, high-low hem. It's like that oversized kind of waffle knit, and it's a cotton blend. So that is absolutely everything for this gigantic 100 item haul. I'm sorry that this was so long, but if you made it to the end, thank you so much. You are a trooper. If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to leave me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys soon. Bye, y'all.